The port of missing men is the Bowery, which remains as colorfully rowdy as it was in the days of Steve Brody's saloon. In the shadow of the elevated, a nickel is still a piece of money, and everything can be bought from a 10-cent necktie to a 30-cent flop, which means a place to sleep. The following scenes are life as it is lived in the Bowery, and were obtained by hiding the camera in a truck. Shuffling figures that once were men beg a dime for a cup of coffee, and when successful, hurry away to a phony barber shop, where the cup of coffee becomes a nip of rot-gut whiskey, which for the moment at least softens the pain of a lifelong misery. Sidewalk scavengers without the price of a smoke pick gutter snipes, but don't let them catch you watching. Hash houses carpeted with sawdust serve a full meal for 30 cents, while a creaky organ wheezes a religious mission song without cover charge. Three big donuts and a cup of coffee can be had for a nickel, and 25 cents buys a 7-course turkey dinner. Sidewalk hucksters hawk everything that one needs to wear, and overcoats freshly cleaned and pressed can be bought for $4 and up. This sodden soul has a more serious problem than food. He is wondering why he got this and just what to do with it. He says that 1% of what he made last year is slightly less than a nickel, and he knows the paper costs more than that. So he figures to save the government money and do nothing about it at all. On church steps after dusk are sprawled unfortunates who must be up at the crack of dawn for a front spot in the bread line of Mr. Zero, who somehow manages to obtain food for men who don't seem able to get it for themselves. It is called a tub, and a meal of mulligan, coffee, and pie may be had for a nickel. Mothers' sons who have lost their grip on life are gratefully happy for the bite of hot food. And Mr. Zero deserves his name, for he is the last hope of the street of forgotten men.